There's been a lot of great updates to MIDI editing in Live 12, and I want to show you some of the changes of how Chance works now. So we can select Chance by clicking down here on this drop-down menu and showing Chance. And the way Chance works is every single note gets a probability that it will play. I'm going to select all of these notes, and I can just drag these chances down. Let's put them all down to 24%. So now all of these notes will play 24% of the time. So right now it's pretty sparse because it's about 1 in 4. We can adjust this and bring it up. We're going to hear more notes. You can always tell that there's chance going on because there's this little black corner on the MIDI note. Let's bring this all the way up to 100%. Now the black corner goes away, and we can hear every note as you would normally expect. Live 12 now gives us the opportunity to just randomize with the click of a button. So I'm going to randomize these chances. Since I have nothing selected, all of the notes will be randomized. And we can see we got these different values in the chances. And it's determined by this percentage slider. So we will get a value within 50% of wherever the chance has been set. So that's from 100 to 50 in this case. And we've got a whole different variety of note chances. And now sometimes the notes play, sometimes they don't, about half the time. We can change it with the slider if we want. We can adjust it in real time. Make it more drastic. We can just click it again and get all new values and relationships between those randomizations. Very nice. I'm going to bring everything back up to 100%. And I'm going to open another MIDI clip. And now we have some notes that I've deactivated. So I wanted to add a little spice to this chord progression. So I created these notes that will sit on top of these chords. If I play this right now, this is what we hear. All of these notes always play. But I want just one of those notes to play. So this is where the new group feature comes in. So I'm going to select these notes and go down to group and play one. And now one of these notes will play at whatever chance I determine. So you'll notice we have a triangle here instead of a circle. That indicates that these are grouped notes. And as I adjust this one slider, all three of these notes illuminate. So 50% of the time, one of those notes will play. I'm going to put this all the way up to 100% because I want that one note to play every single time. I'm going to do that for these others as well. Play one, and we can even do that by right-clicking and just selecting group notes, play one, or using Command G. Let's listen to it now. So now one of these three notes are playing. This gives us these interesting chord extensions that will change every single time this clip loops. I've also got some other notes here. So these are just some little ornamental things that I'm going to activate here. I'll let you hear what that sounds like. Just some little offbeat things here. And I'm going to select these and I'm going to go to play all. And now I'm going to bring this chance down to about 50%, let's say. And I'll do this for all four. We play all, about 50% or so. So now 50% of the time, all of those notes will play. I'm able to get a lot of variety in this one four-bar loop by using some chance here to change up the notes and the different chords that are playing. Let's take a look at this drum beat. Pretty simple drum beat I've got using my mode audio trip-hop drums. So we're playing the same kicks and rides every single time, but these tracks have multiple kicks and rides. So I'm going to just add these all right here by just clicking into these, and I'm going to add different ride cymbal hits. Okay, so I'm going to just make this quick and easy. I'm just going to copy these over to here. Every time there's a kick, we'll just play those, and we'll select all of the rides. Now it'll be a little bit easier to see. So we'll select all the rides to play here and here, and we'll do the same thing with these rims. Let's add some rims. We'll fold that down. I'll select these rims and drag them over. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because each one of these kicks and each one of these rides is slightly different. Again, I'm going to select these all and I'm going to group them to play one so that every time this comes around, one of these notes will play. And I'm going to do it a little faster by using the keyboard shortcut Command G. So every time I select a selection of these notes and hit Command G, I'm creating a group that will allow one of them to play every time we go around. And I'm going to leave the percentage at 100% because I always want these to play. Let's hear this. Now if we look at my drum rack, we're getting all different kinds of notes playing back now. It's never quite the same every time it goes around. And that's the same thing with this MIDI clip too. Short loops, but now they have lots of variety. I'm going to also show you now one of the transform features in Live 12. I'm going to select these little chords here. I'm going to hold down shift and just select all of them. And we're going to go into transform and select strum. And this allows me to offset these notes. They all move depending on how I move this little slider here. So we can get these nice little strums here. So that we can hear it every time, I'm going to raise the percentages of these chances all to 100%. A little more personality to those sounds. Let's go the other way. We can change the tension a little. That kind of changes the timing a bit. Again, another fun way you can add a little style and life to these MIDI performances. If you want to learn more about the new features in Ableton Live 12, check out the playlist I made that covers a bunch of these new features that are really fun and exciting. If you want to just learn about music production, check out the Music Production Podcast where we talk about all things related to music. And I've also got tons of Ableton Live packs at my website, brianfunk.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.